Hello students, now we are going to discuss bulk modulus. What is bulk modulus? Actually, it can be defined as within the limit of elasticity, the ratio of normal stress to that of volume strain. Normal stress to that of volume strain is called bulk modulus. I am supposing a balloon having initial volume capital V and is immersed within some liquid in this way. I am supposing this to be the liquid, means a uniform pressure is being applied over the entire volume, so that its volume reduces to V minus delta V. Now what will be the normal stress? Normal stress is equal to force per unit area, that is pressure upon volume strain, and volume strain is what? Change in volume. Change in volume is minus delta V upon V. So this can be written as minus PV upon delta V. This is the bulk modulus. And the unit of bulk modulus is again Newton per meter square. From this relation, it appears that this comes to be negative, but the value of bulk modulus is always positive. Why? Because with increase in the pressure, the volume of this balloon is decreasing, means delta V is negative, and negative upon negative, that will be positive, means bulk modulus is positive. So, this is the bulk modulus, Newton per meter square, and the reciprocal of bulk modulus is called compressibility. The reciprocal of bulk modulus is called compressibility, and compressibility can be written as minus delta V upon P into capital V. So, this is all about bulk modulus and compressibility. Now, come to modulus of rigidity. What is modulus of rigidity? Within the limit of elasticity, the ratio of tensile stress to that of shearing strain is called modulus of rigidity. This is tensile stress to that of shearing strain. I am supposing this is a cuboidal structure in this way, and a tangential force is being applied on this like this. This is the force and this one is the area. I am supposing these points to be A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. After the application of this deforming force, the final structure is something like this. E gets shifted to E dash, F to F dash, G to G dash, and S to S dash. Means the final structure looks like in this way. Here, theta is the shearing strain. In this way, the final structure. So, if theta is the shearing strain, what is the value of modulus of rigidity? This is F upon A and this one is theta. So, this will be F upon U. You can find the value of theta. Theta is equal to what? Theta is equal to perpendicular upon base, and perpendicular is EE dash upon base is AE. So, this is all about the modulus of rigidity. Now come to Poisson's ratio. What is Poisson's ratio? It is the ratio of lateral strain to the longitudinal strain. It is the ratio of lateral strain to the longitudinal strain. So Poisson ratio is represented by sigma, and this is lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain. What is lateral strain? I am supposing this is a rod. Its original length is capital L and diameter is capital D. Now, when some deforming force is applied over this rod, then its length increases to capital L plus small l and diameter decreases to capital D minus delta D. So what about the lateral strain? Lateral strain is equal to change in diameter upon original diameter. And what is longitudinal strain? Change in length upon original length. So this can be written as minus delta D upon D, and this will be capital L upon small. This is the value of Poisson ratio. Theoretically, the value of Poisson's ratio ranges from minus 1 to 0.5. Means it is less than 0.5 and more than minus 1. But the practical value of Poisson ratio is from 0 to 0.5. So this is all about Poisson's ratio.